Could you have imagined as a little girl loving animals that you would be literally up close and personal with something like a rhinoceros?
Actually, yes. That was always my goal, always my thought. And you know, when you're little, most children love animals. I think it's a natural thing for humans to love animals. And that affinity just grew in me as I grew up. And so I went to school, studied animal science, studied animal physiology, animal reproduction. And this is a dream job for me. And it's exactly what I wanted to do, but so few people get to do exactly what they want to do. And I feel very fortunate that I got to do exactly what I wanted to do.
I mean, you're with animals every day. Mm-hmm. Do you ever lose that sense of wonder? I mean, every single time you walk down here, do you still get that, holy cow, I'm next to a rhino?
Every time. And when we were just watching the Facebook Live with Marco, and Parker and I were both just as thrilled as could be that we saw this new behavior. It never gets old.
Yeah.
Never gets old. These animals are, they're fascinating. We learned a lot about them, but we learn more about their personalities and their social structure all the time.
I'm going to ask you something very unprofessional, because every once in a while I try to not be a reporter and just think, if I'm just the guy sitting at home watching this thing, what's on my mind? What's it like to stick your arm up a rhino's butt?
It's a little scary because we know that there's a potential danger, but it's, well, we both have had a fair amount of experience palpating domestic animals. So we were kind of used to that. We understand how you go about it so that you don't cause any damage. It's a little scary. It's a little scary that you know, the animal, that we might, you know, upset the animal, although you could see that the animals were not upset. But when you see that ovary and you've successfully done an ultrasound, it feels great.
I mean, when you're at a dinner party with people and they're like, oh, what are you working on? And you say, oh, what did you do at the office today? I mean, people must be like fascinated when you're like, well, I put on a big rubber glove or a big plastic glove.
Some rubber pants. Usually I start out, when people ask me what I do, I say, I work at the zoo. If they're interested, they'll ask another question, and then I go a little bit further. But most people don't want to know the details, the details of what we do. So I don't give those details right up front. I wait to see how interested they really are and sort of assess whether they can take it or not, you know.
So for people who, there's so many people who are following the project that you're doing. I mean, when I was at the zoo a few weeks ago when they were opening up the lemur exhibit, somebody was walking around with a NOLA shirt at the zoo. I mean, people are,
yes,
really, and they're emotionally, mm-hmm, because so many San Diegans had the experience of getting to see NOLA here,
yes,
and understood what she meant. There's an emotional attachment, mm-hmm, there. So how do you feel like a pressure to it that you know, that a big part of the future of the species is in a lot of ways in your hands?
We do. We do feel that. And we feel, you know, every time we hear about the poaching numbers in South Africa, it hurts. It really does. But what we're doing is what the best we can do to ameliorate that. You know, and so we just work harder and we try not to get discouraged. Sometimes it is discouraging when you hear about what's happening in the wild. But we've got these animals here, we have the potential to do something with them, and that's the best we can do to combat that. And it's just work harder. Every time we hear something like that, you know, yeah, you get temporarily a little bit upset, a little bit depressed, but then you just, you know, it spurs us on to work harder, work better, be more thoughtful, care about the animals, you know, talk to people about it so that they understand, so that they care. That's important too.